All right, everyone, welcome back to another episode of Undertale. And today, well, not actually last time, we left off at Toriel's house. And she brought me in here. I got my own room, as you can see. Yeah, so I've been living here for the past few days, and we're continuing off of last time, where Toriel baked me a snail pie, but I actually reset last time. Well, no, not last time, but I actually reset off of off camera, and I replayed it again because I didn't want my game to be on hard mode, because I originally named myself Frisk, and the game was on hard mode. Yeah, so then I renamed myself again when I reset, and I named it Frisky, because I still wanted to keep the name like Frisk, but I just added a Y at the end, and I was like Frisky. But yeah, and then I redid everything, and gameplay was the same for the most part, but the only things that changed was the switches in the beginning of the ruins had labels on them, as to when the first time when I played it, they didn't have labels, so Toriel had to tell me which switches to press. And also, she did not bake snail pie this time. She baked cinnamon butterscotch pie. So now, we're gonna go out here and talk to Toriel, which I think she's in the other room, so let's go over here. She's right there. Hello there, little one. The pie has not cooled down yet. Perhaps you should take a nap. Yes? No? I will. Yes. Sweet dreams. So yeah, I'm gonna go take a nap. If it even lets me, I don't know. Does it let you take a nap if you go here? Oh, it does. I'm sleeping. What is this, a hat? You found a slice of butterscotch cinnamon pie. I literally thought it was a hat. It looked like a hat. I ate it. I think I ate it. Did I eat it? Item. Butterscotch cinnamon pie. Use info draw. Use. I ate the butterscotch cinnamon pie. Your HP was maxed out. Alright. Let's go here. Sorry for all of the mispronunciations and me stuttering in this. I just got home, took a quick shower, so I'm kind of relaxed right now. Hey, Toriel. Up already, I see. I want you to know how glad I am to have someone here. There are so many old books I want to share. I want to show you my favorite bug hunting spot. I've also prepared a curriculum for your education. This may come as a surprise to you, but I have always wanted to be a teacher. Hold on, let me just fix the tripod so it has a better view. Right there would be good for you guys. There you go. Alright. But I have always wanted to be a teacher. Actually, perhaps that isn't very surprising. Still, I am glad to have you living here. Oh, did you want something? What is it? When can I go home? Nothing. What? This is your home now. Would you like to hear about this book I'm reading? Sure, I guess. It is called 72 Uses for Snails. Is one of them pie? I'm pretty sure that's one of them. How about it? How to exit the ruins? Sure, how to exit the ruins. How about an exciting snail fact? Did you know that snails sometimes flip their digestive systems as they mature? Interesting. How to exit the ruins. Yeah, I want to leave, please. I have to do something. Stay here. Where are you going? Just gonna abandon me here? I thought I lived here with you now, and you're just leaving me here. You know what? Hold on, let me fix this again. I gotta get a better view for you all. Right... here should be good. Right here. Right there. No, it just made it go down a bit. That's good. That's better. Right here. There, that's good. Alright, we're gonna continue. So, if I go down here, I think she might pull me away, or she could either be down here already. Nope, she's already here. You wish to know how to return home, do you not? Ahead of us lies the end of the ruins. A one-way exit to the rest of the underground. I'm going to destroy it. What? No! No one will ever be able to leave again. Now be a good child and go upstairs. Hey, get back here. Where are you going? Every human that falls down here meets the same fate. I have seen it again and again. They come, they leave, they die. You naive child, if you leave the ruins, they, Asgore, will kill you. I'm only protecting you. Do you understand? Go to your room. Do not try to stop me. This is your final warning. Please. You want to leave so badly? You are just like the others. There is only one solution to this. Prove yourself. Prove to me you are strong enough to survive. Oh shit. Uh-oh. I'm just gonna talk to you. You couldn't think of any conversation topics. No! You're literally my mother and I'm fighting you! You're my new mother and I'm fighting you! Alright. Toriel. 80 defense. Knows best for you. Oh, crap. I don't want to fight. I don't have anything on me right now. Wait, why would I leave? That is right. Go upstairs. Okay, look, I'm just gonna go for now. And I will be back, Toriel, but I gotta bring my health up real quick so I can just... Yeah, well, that I just wanna save and bring my health up. So I'll go do that. Oh yeah, and last time I was here, I don't know, cause I reset like twice, but I only came up to this part after I reset like those few times, but last time, I think I found a knife here, a toy knife. Was it around here? It was over here. There was a toy knife, so yeah. And then there was a frog. Ribbit, just between you and me, I saw Toriel come out of here just a little while ago. She was carrying some groceries. I didn't ask what they were for. We're all too intimidated to talk to her, Ribbit. Alright. Let's keep going. And we can go down here. Back to the house. Back to where Toriel is. Down to the basement. And I don't want to fight her again. I just gotta get past her. Because I don't want to hurt Toriel. I'm trying to do a true pacifist route. Yeah, I don't think I ever mentioned that. The only reason I reset is because I want to do a true pacifist route. So yeah, let's try to get to that. What will it take for you to learn your lesson? I'm trying to do my true pacifist route so that, you know, I just don't want to kill anyone. And, oh crap. No, I'm out of here. All right, I'm gonna go back and save again, because that's the best way to get my health up. Takes really long to get on this path. Just gotta keep going up the stairs. Right here. And then we're gonna go back. Because I really wanna get past her. So I can get to the rest of the underground. I wanna be Sands. I wanna be Papyrus. I wanna be Alphys. She looks like Lisa Simpson. Yeah, I really want to meet all those other monsters, and Toriel is getting in my way. Alright. Back here again. I don't want to fight you. Certainly don't want to fight. I certainly... Oh, no. Yep, I should have never done that. Oh no. Oh! I don't want to have to fight her. I don't want to have to kill her either. Oh no. It's snowing fire. It'll get fireballs. What am I doing? I'm trying not to kill you. I don't want to fight you. I think she's purposely pushing those out of the way. Fight me or leave. She's purposely doing that. Alright. Fine, I'll fight you. I can try to get hit, she'll just push those. I don't want to kill her. Yeah, she purposely pushes those things away from me so I don't die. I kind of don't want to hurt her, but... I even tried sparing her, but she just wants to fight. No, please, no! You are stronger than I thought. Listen to me, small one. If you go beyond this door, keep walking as far as you can. Eventually, you will reach an exit. Don't die on me, do not die on me! Asgore, do not let Asgore take your soul. His plan cannot be allowed to succeed. I don't want you dying on me. Be good, won't you, my child? No! No. Oh no. Oh no. Well, I guess we're resetting. Okay, so we're back because I did not want to kill Toriel. I just played for my last save point, so we're just gonna see what happens if I try not to kill her. Because I don't want Toriel dying. So we're just gonna keep sparing her, see what happens. Oh! Alright. I don't want you dead, Toriel. Trust me. It already hurt me so much the last time. These are just fictional characters. I already feel bad for killing them. Ugh. I don't want to kill her. I just feel bad doing it. She's trying to keep me safe, and I'm hurting her. I guess I have to fight. Mercy. I'll spare you. I can try getting myself hurt. She just makes the attacks get dodged. But she purposefully misses the attacks, so I won't get hurt. Okay, I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna try getting her health all the way down. Or I can try getting myself hurt, but why would I even want to do that? See, look, She purposefully, sorry for always mispronouncing that, misses the attacks. I can try getting hit, I can't. She's trying to save me. Pretty scared at the top. Alright. No! Oh my gosh. Not again. Not again. Not again. You know, screw that. We're resetting again. We're back again after I felt bad for like the second time. So right now we're just gonna take a nap because, you know, I just wanna take a nap. That's all. Frisky, please. Wake up. You're the future of humans and monsters. Oh, I'm up. Oh, this music is pretty cool, by the way. Like, I love the soundtrack in this game. Wow, I just want to wander and listen to this. I can go to bed again? Frisky, please. Wake up. Oh, same dialogue. Alright, well, I guess we'll go back down. And we'll go meet Toriel again. I don't know how I feel about killing her. I don't know, that feels like the only option right now, which is for me to attack her, but I don't know, maybe I can spare her at the end because I just kept spamming the attack button and then it eventually killed her, like both times. So we'll do this again. Mercy. Oh crap, I don't want to use that on her. Alright, just gotta focus. Alright, don't get hurt, don't get hurt. Alright. Sorry for not a lot of commentary on the way on these battles, I'm just really focused. I can run away! Yeah, but I'm not trying to hurt you. What are you proving this way? Okay, well, fight me or leave. Oh crap. Stop it. So this is the part where she starts feeling bad. Ah, if I use this. I feel bad for using a knife. I don't know if, I think that might make my attack stronger, but I feel bad. Oh, I did it on the wrong part. Alright. And try talking again. That's creepy, yeah. Seeing her die is creepy. And I kept resetting this. Can you show mercy without fighting or running away? Yeah, I don't want to tell her I saw her die, but... stop looking at me that way. I don't want to keep having to kill you. There has to be another way to do this without running away. Maybe I can make her feel bad to the point where she just like spares me. Well, no, she technically is sparing me right now. Because she doesn't want me to die. She's purposely missing all these attacks. She just gets even more sad. I know you want to go home, but... but please go upstairs now. I promise I will take good care of you here. I know we do not have much, but we can have a good life here. Why are you making this so difficult? Please, go upstairs. She looks sad. Huh. Pathetic, is it not? I cannot save even a single child. No, I understand. You would just be unhappy, trapped down here. The ruins are very small once you get used to them. It would not be right for you to grow up in a place like this. My expectations, my loneliness, my fear. For you, my child, I will put them aside. Oh, if you truly wish to leave the ruins, I will not stop you. However, when you leave, please do not come back. I hope you understand. Aww. Oh, wait, I wasted all my screenshot space yesterday. Goodbye, my child. Alright, I guess that's it for me and Toriel and our, like, mother, son, daughter, whatever gender Frisk is, relationship. Goodbye, Toriel. Alright, we're walking down this path. We're seeing what happens. Alright. And that's the end. Oh no. Clever. Very clever. You think you're really smart, don't you? In this world, it's kill or be killed. So you were able to play by your own rules. You spared the life of a single person. But don't act so cocky. I know what you did. You murdered her. And you went back because you regret- I actually did, and you know that. I felt bad. You naive. Stop. Stop. Do you think you are the only one with that power? The power to reshape the world? Purely by your own determination? The ability to play God! The ability to save. I thought I was the only one with that power, but I can't save anymore. Apparently, your desires for this world override mine. Well, well. Enjoy that power while you can. I'll be watching. Damn! You're really taking this seriously, aren't you? It's almost personal. And then you're just gone? Alright. What the... Undertale again. There it is. That was only the intro of the game. So now I'm actually, like, about to play the next segment of the game. Undertale by Toby Fox. There it is. Hi. Alright, we're in like a snowy area. This door is locked. I'm gonna walk down this path. Let's see. I'm in like a creepy forest. There's a stick there, which I can obviously walk around. That cracked by itself. I never stepped on it. Alright, let's keep going. This creepy slender forest is making me pretty scared. Uh-oh. What's that noise? I feel like I know who it is. Human. Don't you know how to greet a new pal? Turn around and shake my hand. Who is it? Yeah, I knew it. Hey, Sans. The old whoopee cushion in the hand trick. It's always funny. Anyways, you're a human, right? That's hilarious. I'm Sans. Sans the skeleton. Hi, Sans. I'm actually supposed to be on watch for humans right now. But, you know... I don't really care about capturing anybody. Now my brother, Papyrus, he's a human hunting fanatic. Hey, actually, I think that's him over there. I have an idea. Go through this gate thingy. Yeah, go right through. My bro made the bars too wide to stop anyone. Quick, behind that conveniently shaped lamp. Sup, bro?
You know what? Sup, brother. It's been 8 days and you still haven't recalibrated your puzzles. You just hang around outside your station. What are you even doing?
Staring at this lamp. It's really cool. Do you want to look?
No! I don't have time for that! What if a human comes through here? I want you to be ready! I will be the one! I must be the one! I will capture a human! Then I, the great Papyrus, will get all the things I utterly deserve. Respect, recognition, I will finally be able to join the Royal Guard. People will ask to be my friend. I will bathe in a shower of kisses every morning.
Maybe this lamp will help you.
Sans! What are you? You are not helping, you lazy bones. All you do is sit and boondoggle. You get lazier and lazier every day.
Hey, take it easy. I've gotten a ton of work done today. A skeleton.
Sans!
Come on, you're smiling.
I am, and I hate it! Why does someone as great as me have to do so much just to get some recognition?
Wow, sounds like you're really working on yourself. Down to the bone. I think I said that wrong. I think it was meant to be... Wow, sounds like you're really working yourself down to the bone. There, that's better.
Ugh!
Wait, why did I say it like that?
Ah! I will attend to my puzzles! As for your work, hold a little more! Backbone into it! Yeah! Heh!
Okay, you can come out now.
Why, thank you, Sans.
You ought to get going. He might come back. And if he does, you have to sit through more of my hilarious jokes. What's the holdup? Look, there's nothing to be afraid of. It's just a dark cavern filled with skeletons and horrible monsters. Well, you ought to get going. He may come back. And if he does... Yeah, he already said that. I like this lamp. It's like the same shape as me. It's a really... It's a really nice lamp you got there, Sans. I love that lamp. Really nice lamp. Alright. Bye, Sans. Actually, hey. Hate to bother you, but... Can you do me a favor? I was thinking. My brother's been kind of down lately. He's never seen a human before. And seeing you might just make his day. Don't worry. He's not dangerous. Even if he tries to be. Thanks a million. I'll be up ahead. Alright, well, you're welcome, Sans. I'm gonna help you out now. The convenience of that lamp fills you with determination. Snowden Road. Snowden Box Road. What's this? Use this box? What is this? Tough glove. I'll take that. Thank you. I'll just say, this is a box. Do you put an item inside or take an item out? The same box will appear later, so don't worry about coming back. Sincerely, a box lover. Damn. Just flee. I'm just gonna flee. I got better to do. Okay, I wanna see what this is. What's this way now?
So, as I was saying about Undyne.
They're looking at each other. They're looking at each other. They're really looking at each other.
Sans! Oh my god! Is that a human?
Actually, I think that's a rock.
Oh!
Hey, what's that in front of that rock?
Oh my god! Is that a human?
Yes, it's a human.
Oh my god! Sans, I finally did it. I'll be so popular! Human, you shall not pass this area. I, the great Papyrus, will stop you. I will then capture you You will be delivered to the capital.
Then,
I'm not sure what's next. In any case, continue only if you dare.
Well, that went well. Don't sweat it, kid. I'll keep an eye socket out. Shoot. Excuse me for that one. I'll keep an eye socket out for you. Damn. I'll keep an eye socket out for you. Alright. Well, thanks, Sans. And I guess I don't want to get involved in this. Escaped. There's some narration on this cardboard box. You observe the well-crafted sentry station. Who could have built this, you ponder. I bet it was that very famous royal guardsman. Note, not yet a very famous royal guardsman. There's some okay, I already read all that. Nope, I'm clicking it again by accident. Alright, let's go. So yeah, thank you, Sans. And, nice meeting you, Papyrus. Alright, absolutely no moving! What's this? Did something move? Was it my imagination? I can only see moving things. If something was moving, for example, a human, I'll make sure it never moves again. Don't move an inch. I guess he hates me moving. Oh, crap. Moving? Moving? Doggo is confirming the moving object. It moved. It didn't not move. Oh, okay, so if I don't move, it won't hit me. Doggo can't seem to find anything. Will it move this time? Doggo can't seem to find anything. You pet Doggo. What? I've been pet! Pat. Doggo has been pet. You pet Doggo. Where's that coming from? Pet. Doggo has been pet. You pet Doggo. There's no end to it. Pet. Doggo has been pet again. Doggo, attack. Will it move this time? Pet. I am going to keep it. You won! You're in 0 XP and 30 gold. Something. Pet me. Something. That isn't moving. I'm gonna need some dog treats for this. Bye-bye! Someone's been smoking dog treats. They certainly have. Hey, Sans. Hey, here's something important to remember. My brother has a very special attack. If you see a blue attack, don't move and it won't hurt you. Here's an easy way to keep it in mind. Imagine a stop sign. When you see a stop sign, you stop, right? Stop signs are red, so imagine a blue stop sign instead. Simple, right? When fighting, think about blue stop signs. Alright, thanks. Thank you, Sans. Oh, crap, I just slid across that. I really want to read that sign, so, no, crap. North. Ice. South. Ice. West. Ice. East. Snowdentown. And ice. North ice. Alright. So, what is this way? No, I got better to do. Trying to do a true pacifist group.
You're so lazy! You were napping all night!
I think that's called sleeping.
Excuses!
Oh, the human arrives!
In order to stop you, my brother and I have created some puzzles! I think you will find this one quite shocking. For you see, this is the invisible electricity maze! When you touch the walls of this maze, this orb will administer a hearty zap. Sounds like fun, because the amount of fun you will probably have is actually rather small than I think. Okay, go ahead now.
Damn,
you?
I think the human has to hold the orb.
Oh, okay. Hold this, please. Okay, try now.
You made some footprints, so like...
Incredible! You slippery snail! You solved it so easily! Too easily! However, the next puzzle will not be so easy. It is designed by my brother, Sans! You will surely be confounded. I know I am! Yeah!
Alright, thank you, Sans. Hey, thanks! Roberto seems like he's having fun. By the way, did you see that weird outfit he's wearing? We made that a few weeks ago for a costume party. He hasn't worn anything else since. Keeps calling it his battle body. Man, isn't my brother cool? Hey, is it just the same things again? How are you? I understand why those aren't selling. It's something perfect for... It's the perfect weather for something cold.
Oh, a customer! Hello! Would you like some ice cream? It's the frozen treat that warms your heart!
Now just 15G.
Yes, sir.
Here you go. Have a super duper day. You got an ice cream. Alright, let's check my inventory. Nice cream.
You're super spiffy. Your HP was maxed out.
Yeah, I bought something for you. Snowball. This is cool. Oh, hey, Sans.
I've been thinking about selling treats, too. Want some frat snow?
It's just 5G.
Did I say 5G? I meant 50G.
You're right. That's still too low.
What if I actually accept? What about 5,000G?
I'm embarrassed because I don't know how to read that number.
What? You don't have that money.
Hey, that's okay. I don't have any snow. Alright, I'm just gonna keep kicking this. Until I can get it to move to where I want to go.
Go down here.
Down this way.
Oh, I see something.
Yep.
Purple. Even when you felt trapped, you took notes and achieved the end of the ball. End of ball. You are awarded 2G. There's a camera hidden inside this lump of snow.
It looks like a snowball.
Actually, it's a snowdecahedron.
Whatever that means. However you pronounce it. What's this way?
Human! I hope you're ready for...
What is this?
Sans! Where's the puzzle?
It's right there. On the ground. Trust me, there's no way they can get past this one.
Monster Kids Word Search. Hey kids, can you help me solve this puzzle?
Fall, monsters. No, fall, monster, cigars, winter, skeletons, cig, spring, mermaid,
got.
Alright, well, is there any way to do it?
Sans! That didn't do anything!
Whoops. I knew I should have used today's crossword instead.
What? Crossword? I can't believe you said that! In my opinion, Junior Jumble is easily the hardest.
What? Really, dude? That's easy peasy. What am I doing? This dumb sucks for all these characters.
What? Really? What? Really, dude? That easy peasy word scramble? That's for baby bones. Unbelievable! Human, solve this dispute!
Which is harder, jumble or crossword? I just jumbled.
Ha ha ha! Yes! Humans must be very intelligent. They also find Junior Jumble so difficult.
Thanks for saying Junior Jumble, just to appease my brother. Yesterday he got stumped for trying to solve the horoscope. Oh yeah. Thank you, Sans. Knowing the mouse might one day find a way to heat the spaghetti, it fills you up with determination. It's a note from Papyrus.
Human, please enjoy the spaghetti. Little do you know, the spaghetti is a trap. Designed to entice you. You'll be so busy eating it that you won't realize that you aren't progressing. Thoroughly japed against, again, by the great Papyrus.
Papyrus. Alright, let me go around this. See the mouse? Nice. Now I guess I'm saving it again. It's a plate of frozen spaghetti. It's so cold, it's stuck to the table. It's an unplugged microwave. All the settings would say spaghetti. Warning, dog marriage. What? Did that actually say that? Yes, you read it correctly. Alright, dog marriage. Alright. I do not have time for this. It's over here. What is this? What am I walking on? Is that X marks the spot or something? No, I don't know. I don't know what this is. What is this? Alright. Let's keep going. Nothing over here, so I guess I'm just gonna go back. And yeah, dog marriage. I don't even know what that means, but okay. Sans, you're gone. This was just a crossword. And I hope you guys like my shitty dubbing. I just came up with the voices because of JT Music's To The Bone, so I tried mimicking it, you know? His. Hers. Smell danger rating. Snow smell. Snowman. White rating. Can become yellow rating. Unsuspicious smell. Puppy blue rating. Smell of rolling around. Weird smell. Humans green rating. Destroy at all costs. Alright, I guess I'm going back here. Cross this conveniently placed bridge and down this way. To go over here. Hello, I'm a snowman. I want to see the world, but I cannot move. If you would be so kind, traveler, please, take a piece of me and bring it very far away. Thank you. Good luck. You got the snowman piece. Is that in my inventory? There it is. What am I supposed to do? Go back this way? Hello? Is anybody there? No. I'm confused on what I'm supposed to do now. I don't know if I'm supposed to be going... No. Crap. I don't know if I'm supposed to keep going this way. I do not have time for you. Goodbye. So I don't know if I'm supposed to be... Something's just wrong with me today. I don't know if I'm supposed to keep going this way, or go down here, but there's like nothing down here. Except more snow and trees. Wow. Whoa, it's a hole. Yeah, I already pushed this down that hole. Ow. Sans, buddy, where'd you go? I'm desperately looking around for you, and then I want to see if... This is spaghetti. This microwave is unplugged, so it's not gonna do anything. Junior Jumbo. Why would I say that randomly? I don't know. Nope, I'm trying to be a pacifist here. Is there anywhere else to go? Because that thing is like blocked off by spikes. I don't know if I can move these piles of like snow out. Is that snow or rocks? I don't know. All right, this looks like a map actually. So maybe I could look at it. What is this? It says, it looks like it's supposed to be a path or something. I can't clearly read it, but I'm gonna try to make out what it looks like. Yeah, I do not know. I think that is the way, right there, to the right. I'm gonna keep trying and see if I can get over there. And I really can't do anything. You threw the stick away and then picked it back up. Stick. Open at zero. Its bark is worse than its bite. Alright, I'm gonna keep looking around, seeing what I can do. Is this nothing? Oh my gosh. I'm out of here. Alright. It's like 11. I'm pretty tired. I might go to sleep after this. Warning. Dog marriage. Same sign again. I've been looking. There's a switch hidden in the snow. Click. Oh. The switch is stuck now. Oh, okay. I think that did something probably. Yep, it put those spikes down so I can walk over now. Oh, nah. Who are these guys? What's that smell? Where is that smell? If you're a smell, identify yourself. What the? Here's that weird smell. It makes me want to eliminate. Eliminate you! Doggy assaults you. The dogs are too suspicious of your smell. Paws off, you smell human. That's not your husband, okay? Oh no. The dogs are practicing for the next couples contest. Stick. You threw the stick and the dogs ran to get it. You played fetch for a while. Take my wife. My wife's fleas. Don't actually. Take my wife. What? Take my wife's fleas. I will take your fleas if you want me to. I don't know. I mean, I gotta bring you to like, I don't know, like someplace that washes dogs. Can get you a proper bath. Maybe that will get rid of the fleas. Every dog loves to play fetch. Through a stick. Don't touch my hot. Whoa. All right. Oh, I'm dead. Game over. Yeah, you gotta stay determined, Frisky, because I changed the name. So let's do this again. I was here. I'm pretty sure I gotta click the switch again. Yep. Nope, I do not have time for this. Keep going. Down here. Alright, here we are. Oh, this again. We're just gonna skip all this. We already saw all this. I'm just gonna keep skipping through. Take my mouse, please. Don't actually. I don't know how to dodge these attacks. Oh, wait, like that. Every dog loves to play fetch. Equip tough glove. What does that even do? Okay. Whoa! Alright. Oh! What the? Is that Toby Fox? Kick the human tail. Let's kick human tail. No. What? Is that what it meant? No. Was I reading that right?
Oh, they said blue hearts don't hurt you. Oh, wait. He meant that for Papyrus's battles, didn't he? Oh. Alright. Keep throwing the stick until I do something. Gosh. Oh, oops. Oh. Do I have an item to help me? No. Stick. Let's get human tail. Do humans have tails? No, they don't. Mercy. You won! You earned 0 XP and 40 gold. Weird smells can bring good things. Friendly fun fetch. Thanks, Weird Smell. It sure was fun to stick together. Alright, I can go now. Those guys are in my way. What is this? What? Let's see what this means. Turn every X into an O, then press the switch. Huh? Oh. Oh.
What? How did you avoid my trap? And more importantly, is there any left for me?
What do you tell Papyrus about his spaghetti? Ate it, left it.
Really? Wowie, you resisted the flavor of my home-cooked pasta. Just so you know, could you share with me?
Sorry.
Fret not, human. I, Master Chef Papyrus, will make you all the pasta you could ever want.
Sorry, I'm getting tired of hearing that voice. It's like hurting my throat.
My brother started a sock collection recently. How saddening. Sometimes I wonder what he would do without such a cool guy taking care of him. Yeah.
Alright, yeah. Yeah, alright, let's keep going.
Human! How do I say this? You were taking a long time to arrive, so I decided to improve this puzzle by arranging the snow to look more like my face. Unfortunately, the snow froze to the ground. Now the solution is different. And as usual, my lazy brother is nowhere around. I suppose what I am saying is, worry not, human. I, the great Papyrus, will solve this conundrum. Then we can both proceed. Meanwhile, feel free to try the puzzle yourself. I'll try not to give away the answer.
Turn every X into an O and press the switch. Yeah, easy. Peasy. Maybe I could have, like, went the other way. Like... Okay, I just ruined it now. I literally just ruined it now. I'm gonna press the switch again to reset it. Maybe I have to like, yeah. And then I can go back around to here. And then, yeah. Step on this last one. And then, go.
Wow! You solved it! And you did it without my help. Incredible! I'm impressed. You must care about puzzles like I do. Well, I'm sure you'll love the next puzzle then. It might even be too easy for you. Yeah!
Alright. Thank you. Thank you for that puzzle, Papyrus. Good job on solving it so quickly. You didn't even need my help. Which is great, because I love doing absolutely nothing. Yeah, you're lazy, Sans, I know. Alright, see you soon.
Hey! It's the human! You're gonna love this puzzle. It was made by the great Dr. Alphys. You see these tiles? Once I throw this switch, they will begin to change color. Each color has a different function. Red tiles are impassable. You cannot walk on them. Yellow tiles are electric. They will electrocute you. Green tiles are alarm tiles. If you step on them, you will have to fight a monster. Orange tiles are orange scented. They'll make you smell delicious. Blue tiles are water tiles. Swim through if you like, but if you smell like oranges, the piranhas will bite you. Also, if a blue tile is next to an A, why did I say it like that? If a blue tile is next to a yellow tile, the water will also zap you. Purple tiles are slippery. You will slide to the next tile. However, the slippery soap smells like lemons, which piranhas do not like. Purple and blue are okay. Finally, pink tiles. They don't do anything. Step on them all you like. How was that? Understand?
Understand that, I guess.
Great. Then there's one last thing. This puzzle is entirely random. When I pull the switch, it will make a puzzle that has never been seen before. Not even I will know the solution. Get ready.
Wow. It's just a dance floor now. Oh. Actually, that spaghetti from earlier, it wasn't too bad for my brother. So he started cooking lessons, he's been improving a lot. I bet if he keeps it up, next year he'll be able to make something edible. Shit. I bet if he keeps it up, next year he'll be able to make something edible. I bet if he keeps it up, he'll be able to make something edible next year. Hey, dog. This dog is staring blankly into the snow, waiting for it to turn into art. Alright. On the floor inside is a box of Palmer raisins. Did I read that right? I'm sorry. Where of dog? Please. Pet dog. Please pet the dog. Alright. Knowing that dog will never give up trying to make the perfect snow dog fills you with determination. Who's that? That dog considers itself an artist, but doesn't ever know what to create. It probably doesn't help it that its brain is the size of a piece of kibble. Oh, what's this? Oh. It's a lump of snow with the word sands written on it with red marker. It's a snow papyrus. Nice. I assume I already know what to do. But yeah, I just fucked up, so I'm going to... Nope. Fall off. Go back up. Here we are. No! I just messed up. Alright. Here you go. Crap. Nope. Yeah, if you put ice with puzzles, it's kind of harder. Just think about that papyrus. Well, it was meant to be like that, but, you know. No! You know what, never mind. I'm just gonna use the D-pad for this. Why am I even bothering to try? Yeah, why am I even trying? Hold on. I assume if I turn all of them to O's, something will happen. Yes. There it is. A bridge. And I'm blocked all by all this wood. And I slide out. It's over here. Lumps of snow. And what a tiny doghouse. Woof. Wait. Oh. Could that be a dog? What is it? It's a dog. Nice dog. Oh, wow. I did not expect that. It's the greater dog. Greater dog is too far away to pet. You just pet the air. Alright. Greater dog. I'll... Wait. Greater dog is not excited enough to play with. Okay. Item. Stick. Seriously, the dog ran to get it. You played fetch with it for a while. Oh crap, I do not want to do that. Nope, no sir. Spare. You won! You earned 0 XP and 40 gold. Aw. What a nice dog. Goodbye. Oh, okay. You kinda put your tail on the wrong side. This bridge looks very unstable. Oops.
Human! This is your final and most dangerous challenge. Behold the Gauntlet of Deadly Terror. When I say the word, it will fully activate. Cannons will fire. Spikes will swing. Blades will slice. Each part will swing violently up and down. Only the tiniest chance of victory will remain. Are you ready? Because I am about to do it!
I'm waiting. Well, what's the hold up?
Hold up? What hold up? I'm about to activate it now!
Waiting. That, doesn't look very activated.
Well, this challenge, it seems, maybe, too easy to defeat the human with. Yeah, we can't use this one. I am a skeleton with standards. My puzzles are very fair. And my traps are expertly cooked. But this method is too direct. No class at all. Away it goes! Phew. What are you looking at? This was another decisive victory for Papyrus.
Alright, well, I thought this bridge was gonna fall or something, but that's fine. I don't know what my brother's gonna do now. If I were you, I'd make sure I understand blue attacks. Okay. Welcome to Snowden! Here I am, guys, at Snowden. After a long time of filming, and yeah, the sight of a friendly town fills you with determination. Oh, let's go in the shop. Hello, traveler. How can I help you? Buy? Tough glove. What would you like to buy? Wooden. 5AT, 0T. Slap him. Armor. It has abs on it. Can I sell? Huh? Sell something? Does it look like a pawn shop? I don't know how it works here. I mean, I don't know where it works where you come from, but if I start spending money on old branches and use bandages, I'd be out of business in a jiffy. Take your time. I really want to sell to you. Okay, bye. Bye now. Coming in sometime. I saw the Delta rune behind that guy. Right there. Okay, bye. Snowden's really cool. Welcome to the Snowden Inn, Snowden's premier hotel. One night is 80 G. Well, feel free to come back anytime. Is that a dog? Moms say that sleeping can recover your health above your maximum HP. What's maximum HP? Huh? Okay. Well, I'm here now. There. No, I don't. what's in here. Whoa. Okay. Wow. Yeah, wow. You go through that very fast, Frisk. Don't want to walk to the other side of... don't want to walk to the other side of town? Try the under snow tunnels. They're efficiently laid out. Alright, yeah, that is pretty fast. I'll talk to you. That lady over there. Something about her disturbs me. Isn't my cute little Cinnamon just the cutest? Bun buns are so adorable. Teehee. Bun 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 bun. Oh, is it Christmas for these guys? Yeah, Christmas was like a month ago. But I love celebrating Christmas. It's one of my favorite holidays. And my birthday is in the same month as Christmas. I love this. Awful teens tormented a local monster by decorating its tree like horns. So we started giving that monster presents to make it feel better. Oh, okay, cool. Now it's a tradition to put presents underneath a decorated tree. Nice, nice. Yo, you're a kid too, right? I can tell because you're wearing a striped shirt. Nice. This town doesn't have a mayor. If there's ever a problem, a skeleton will tell a fish lady about it. That's politics. Nice. Well, Grillby's. Nice.
You better watch it when you sit down in here, kid. Because that big guy will jump you.
That big guy will jump into your lap and give you lots of attention. Give you lots of love and attention. We're centuries, but we never get any respect. I wish those skeletons would throw us a bone. We love bones. Okay, that's all it is. There's a lot of dogs in here with this. No matter where I go, it's the same menu, the same people. Help, I want new drinks and hot guys. Isn't human food different from monster food? It does things like spoil. And when you eat it, it passes all the way through your whole body. Disgusting. I'd love to try it sometime. The capital is getting pretty crowded, so I've heard they're going to start moving here. I won't want to see the erasure of our local culture, but I definitely want to see some city slickers slip onto their butts. The jukebox is broken. Grilbs said that he'd offer you a glass of water, but he doesn't touch the stuff. Those dogs are part of the Royal Guard, the elite military group led by a nun. She's rude, loud, and beats up everybody who gets in her way. It's no wonder all the kids want to be like her when they grow up. I'm stuck. Oh, wait. Yeah. I put out a line for some girls today. Someone told me that there are plenty of fish in the sea. Well, I'm taking that seriously. I'm literally going to make out with fish. Wow. Yeah, okay. It's playing poker against itself. It appears to be losing. I'm thinking of getting a spiked collar to show off my personality. It makes a statement like, attach a leash to me and take me for a walk, please. Alright, nice. I went to Grillby's and I found all these guys were here. Was there a back door? I swear I saw a back door. Oh, but I can't get to it. Yeah, and it seems like there's a lever by the back door. So I might go around back. Nope, I can't go around back at all. Yep, alright. There's like a house here, so I'm gonna go. Yeah, never mind. Alright, well, I've already went to the shopping inn, so before we end this video, I think I'm going to check out this part of town, which is the end. Someone's mailbox is crammed. It's a mailbox overflowing with unread junk mail. This is probably Sans' mailbox. This mailbox is labeled Papyrus. Yep, I knew it. Look inside? Yes, it's empty. Papyrus reads all his mail, Sans just doesn't. Library. That look in your eye. Someone that has difficulty solving Junior Jumble, aren't you? Yes, I have a lot of difficulty solving Junior Jumble. It's really hard. I love working on the newspaper. There's so little to report that we just fill it with our comics and games. Nice, nice. When I was younger, my teachers gave me word searches when they ran out of assignments. I thought they were a waste of time. But look at me now. I'm the number one word search creator in the entire underground. Nice, nice. Right over here. Welcome to the library. Yes, we know the sign is misspelled. Is it really? Library. Oh, yeah, it is. I can't read anything. While monsters are mostly made of magic, human beings are mostly made of water. Humans with their physical forms are far stronger than us. But they will never know the joy of expressing themselves through magic. They'll never get a bullet pattern birthday card. It's a school report about monster funerals. Monster funerals, technically speaking, are cool as heck. When monsters get old and kick the bucket, they turn to dust. At funerals, we take that dust and spray it on the person's favorite thing. Then their essence will live on in that thing. Am I at the page minimum yet? I'm kind of sick of writing this. Yeah, okay. Here I am, writing this book. Person comes in and picks up my book. They start reading it. Oh, sorry, I'm still writing that one. Because they are made of magic, monsters' bodies are attuned to their souls. If a monster doesn't want to fight, its defenses will weaken. And the cooler the intentions of our enemies, the more their attacks will hurt us. Therefore, if a being with a powerful soul struck with the desire to kill, let's end the chapter here. Monster History Part 4. Fearing the humans no longer. We moved out of our old city. Home. We braved the harsh, cold, damp, swampland in searching heat. Scorching heat, I think. Until we reached what we now call our capital. New home! Again, our king is really bad at names. Love, hope, compassion. This is what people say that the monster's souls are made of. But the absolute nature of soul is unknown. After all, humans have proven their souls don't need these things to exist. Alright, nice. I read a lot in the library. Now, let's go to Sans and Papyrus' house. I'm pretty sure this is their house. Wait, I don't want to go in here. Continue. It's locked from the inside. Alright. And that's just the way back to the other side of town, and it's locked. Alright, they're not here. Probably. I'm just gonna get in here. And sorry if my voice sounds really weird. Yeah. Alright, I guess I'm gonna save here. And that is gonna be it for this episode of Undertale. So, I hope you guys enjoyed our journey with Frisk so far. We are in Snowdin right now, and we'll see you all in the next one. And this genderless child is gonna peace out again, so peace. And we'll see you later. Yeah. Alright, see you guys soon, and bye.
We can relate to your determination.